Welcome back guys, welcome back to my channel. Today in this short tutorial I will show you guys how to create this cool 3D brush stroke effect in Adobe Illustrator. Before we start, let's see our sponsorship message. Today's video is brought to you by Domestika. Domestika is a platform specially designed to provide courses related to art, design, photography, fashion, and music and audio. So you guys will find exclusively content related to art and design in this platform. You guys can start learning as a beginners or even intermediate and advanced users with advanced courses. And if you guys sign up with the link under the description below, you guys will get special discount. And also if you use the code in the description below to any of the courses, you will get extra 10% off as well. So sign up today and enjoy the Domestika. Alright guys, so first thing what I'm going to do in here is I'm going to select the align segment tool and draw some lines. Make sure your lines are all not same length. Make them little bit different sizes like this. Alright? Okay. I think 5 lines for a start is fine. Now just place it in here. And if you guys don't see your brushes in your UI, go to Windows and open the brush from the Windows. Okay? Or you guys can press F5 also. Okay? So once you open your brush, go to the brush library and in here, inside artistic brushes, select the artistic paint brush. Okay? Which will open up this artistic paint brushes and we can close the brushes for now. Alright, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select each of these lines and going to apply these brushes randomly. Okay, going to start with the splash and for this one, maybe this one in here and for this. So what I'm looking for is something like this. I want to have these brush splashes so that our final artwork will look nicer. Okay, and also let's have some variations, something like this. This one we can have as a background and this one in here as well. Okay, all right so for now I'm just going to keep it like this in here and select each of these brushes and make the stroke with bit higher. Okay, something like this is fine, and this one also 3 and 4, and for this I will add in like 3, and this one can have 4 because maybe this one I'm going to have it 5. And this one may be 2. Now I will select this. Let's bring it in here and go to my libraries. I have different colors in my libraries. You guys can also go in here and apply the color, or you can have your own colors. So what I'm looking in here is some different variations of colors so that it will look nicer in our final artwork. Okay, so for this I'm going to apply maybe this color in here. You have to select the stroke. We cannot apply fill color. So I will deselect the fill color. I will select the stroke and apply this color in here. Okay. And for this also, I'm going to apply the same color. And for this, maybe a lighter tone. And for the background, let's apply a bit a darker tone like this. And for this, maybe a green color. Okay. Now let's bring this one in here and right click, arrange, send it to background. And this one, I will just place it on top like this. This one, let's bring it in here. And this one, let's bring it in here. So what I'm looking is something like this. So I want to have these lines in one side. So it will look nicer. And this one also, I'm just going to bring it in here. Maybe for this, let's bring the brush, the length of the stroke a little bit shorter like this. And I will go back to the properties and increase the stroke size. Okay. All right. Looks good. Let's bring it in here. And I'm going to make a copy. And this one, I'm going to place it in here. And again, I will bring the stroke length a bit shorter. And we can place it like this. All right. Looks good. It will look nicer if we have more variations of colors in these places. So what I will do is let's go in and draw some lines again. And for this, I will select another darker tone, maybe this one in here. And then select this color. And let's go into properties and increase. And we can bring this one in here. All right. And maybe we can turn it around so we can go to the mirror tool and we can mirror it to vertical like this. Okay. Right. Also bring it behind a bit like this is fine. Okay. Now let's have some small dots and lines in here. For that, I'm going to select and some shorter lines like this and apply these colors. Okay. For them also, let's select the colors which we have chosen earlier. Okay. Couple more. That is better. All right. Like that, you guys can have your own brushes. All I want is some splashes in here so that our artwork will look nicer in the final design. Okay. Now, let's make it a little bit smaller. And now I'm going to select these and make a copy, Alt-Z. And this one, I'm just going to place it in here. Okay. I want to make this one a little bit longer. So that's what I'm doing in here. Maybe a little bit thicker also. All right. So let's place it like that. And again, Alt-Z and place it in here like this. And you guys can play around with this and get a different shape. All right. And let's add in a little bit more lines in here as well. I'm just randomly place these lines in here. So we will have this nice brush stroke look in here. Okay. I think this is good enough for this artwork. So I'm going to select all of them. And now we can delete this. We don't need this anymore. So I'm going to hide the brush stroke. Now select all of them and make as a group. Okay. We have this group. Now go to Windows again and activate the symbols. Okay. If you guys already have symbols here, you can go straight to the symbols and select this and drag and drop into a symbol, which will create a new symbol in your symbol settings. And for this, I'm going to name this as brush stroke. All right. Okay. Now we can delete this. We can close this. And also, we don't need this anymore. We can delete this. All right. And also, okay, so now if you guys let's go back to the symbols in here. If you guys see, we have created this symbol. You can just place it in here. You can see our brush stroke is saved as a symbol. Now you can delete this. I'm going to delete this again. Now I'm going to draw the shape which we are going to apply that symbol for. Okay, and for that, I'm going to select the pen tool in here and draw a shape like this. Start from here. And okay, all the way here. Don't worry too much when you are drawing, guys. Later also we can edit. For now, I'm just drawing the basic shape. Later we can get the perfect shape we wanted. Okay. Now you can use your direct selection tool and make it smoother. And you don't have to worry too much at this point. Later, once you apply these settings, we can edit it as well. Okay. I'm just going to edit this for a while. All right, now it's look perfect. Now you guys can select this and go to effects and in the 3D select extrude and bevel. Make sure you don't have any fill color for this stroke. And now in here, you guys can rotate the way you want. Okay, you guys can rotate around. So I want something like this shape. Okay, and then be a little bit below like this. And then we can increase the thickness of this by extruding the depth. I'm going to make it something like this. Okay. Extrude it maybe 750 is fine. And now go to the map art. And in here, you guys can see we have the symbols. So if you go and open the symbols, you guys can see the symbol which we have created. So that's what we are going to apply. But we need to select the correct surface. So you can see this surface is not what we are looking for. And you can move these selections by selecting these sections in here. So if you go in here, not this one and this one. So this is the surface we are going to apply that map. So select this and go to the symbols again and select the brush stroke, which will apply the brush stroke on top of this surface like this. Okay. And now select this and make it scale to fit, which will make the brush stroke, which we have created to fit into our artwork. And if you guys see, it has applied properly, but we need these splashes on top for our artwork. So we can just go in and rotate it under 80 degrees. Okay, just rotate it like this. All right, now we can make it a little bit thinner as well. So all our objects will be shown in the design. Okay, looks good. And we don't need this green color, which is the surface from the stroke. So we can select this one in here, invisible geometry, which will hide the stroke color from here. Okay, so once you are all right, just select okay. And in here, you guys can edit the lighting, but we are going to add in lighting manually for this artwork. So for now, if you're okay, just select okay. So now we have this gold shape in here. Now you guys can select the direct selection tool and start editing this shape. Okay, so now when you edit these shapes, you can see our shape is changing like this. Okay, for this I'm going to bring it a bit higher like that, and this one let's bring it. So now you guys can edit this the way you wanted. So I'm going to make some changes. Alright guys, so once you are satisfied, you can actually move this by selecting these anchor points and bringing these changes to the shape. You can see it's simply changing the full shape like this. Okay, now you can see the entire shape is changed. You guys can always go back to the extrude settings from your appearance, and in the map part, you can change the, you can select the correct surface. You guys can always edit these and change the sizes of the surface in here as well. Okay, all right. Okay, guys, so once you are satisfied with your design, you can go to object and expand it. You have to do that couple of times in here. So I'm just going to select it. And now you have to select all of them again, right click, ungroup them, and select only the shapes in here now, and right click, ungroup them again. Now you can see we have these shapes individually, but there are some extra additional things in here which comes from that shape which we have created. So select this again, right click, release the clipping mask, and do that for all of them. Now select only the shapes in here, these shapes. Okay, we have 5-6 shapes in here. And you can just Control X. Now select everything else left in your artwork and delete it. Okay, make sure you don't have anything else in here. Now Shift Control V, place it in place. Now we have this shape as a clean vector object. Okay, now we can add in highlights and shadows. For that, I'm going to start from here. So in here, we need to have shadows in this place and highlighted areas in here. And for this, we will have shadows in here and little bit highlight area in here and shadow again in here. Okay, for that, I will select this, Control C and Shift Control V. So I basically made a copy and place on top. And for this, first, I will go to the Pathfinder and unite all these objects into one. So select this and unite them into one. Now we have one single shape like this. And for this, I will go and apply a gradient, okay, for the fill color, not for the stroke. And we don't need any stroke for this design. And select this. Now press G or select the gradient in here and apply the gradient from here. You make sure you have selected the fill color. Now apply the gradient like this. We need other way around, so it's going to be something like that. Okay, something like that. All right, and now select this and go to the opacity and select the blending mode and apply the multiple. Okay, all right, so now we have nice shadow in here, but we need to bring it behind. All right, so now select this and you can edit the opacity if you want to. I'd say I want like 60%. All right, so now we have the shadow and we can always go into the gradients and edit the shadows in here like this. Okay, I think this looks better. Okay, same for this one also. Now this one comes as one object, so we need shadows in here, and here we are going to have the highlight. So we need to work around with the gradient. So select this, Control C, Shift Control V, and go to Pathfinder and unite them. And for this also, let's select the gradient from here. Okay, now the gradient, select G, and now I'm going to apply the gradient from here, from top all the way to the bottom. And this part is fine, but I need to bring the white color a little bit further down like this. Okay, all right. Now add in one new color, white color in here, and bring it in here, and one more in here. For this, I'm going to apply the black color. Okay, so this one should be somewhere around here. This one I will bring out a bit. All right, this is what I'm looking for. Then let's expand a bit like this. And this one, the white color should be in here. Maybe instead of pure white, let's make it like 200 200 200. Okay, and again I'm going to select the last one, which is going to be in here as black, so all are going to be zero. Okay, all right, maybe we can expand this one a bit. This one also we can expand the gradient a bit. Okay, and this one also we are going to select the blending mode as multiple. All right, now we can bring that behind this layer. Okay, in here. And for this again, going to opacity and make it as 75. You guys can play around with the gradient and get the proper colors you want. And also you can apply different opacity levels for this gradient in here as well, so you will have nice 3D look for this shape. Okay, and next one will be here, this one, and select this, Control C, Shift Control V, and for this make it as one object and get the colors from here. And now we can make this one also as a multiple blending mode object, and now we can bring this one behind. Last one is this one, Control C, Shift Control V, and for this I will get the colors from here. Okay, first we need to make it as one object and get the colors from here, and we can apply the gradient something like that, other way around like this, and make it as a multiple blended object and bring all of these to the background. Now you guys can integrate this one to your artwork and create cool abstract designs like this. You guys can also use this kind of techniques to create your own text styles. You can draw the path as text and create unique wave style text for your artworks as well. Alright guys, so this will be my final design. And thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tutorial.